随着世博的举行，全世界的国家和地区在上海呈现着各自的文化和生活方式，在这个全球的盛会中吸引着许多高端奢侈品牌的参与。今天的节目，我们将带你走进世博，一起去发现世博的奢华元素。在我身后是位于世博西区的比利时馆，作为欧盟总部的所在地，它也有着欧洲首都的称誉。在这个看似平凡的四方体建筑里，隐藏着怎样的精彩呢？让我们一起去一看究竟。现在在比利时馆的餐厅，有幸采访到比利时馆的商业活动总监一天。一天先生你好。
你好。嗯，
可以给我们介绍一下这次比利时馆有没有对于中国旅客推出哪一些商业活动呢？
Well, in the Belgian Pavilion, we have many activities regarding commercial and especially luxury and high-level brands. Belgium is famous especially for diamonds, chocolate, high-class beer. Uh-huh. And so we have tried to bring this in the Shanghai Expo in a friendly way.
来过比利时馆的游客都非常想亲身的去比利时玩一下。那你们对于大量的中国旅客有没有推出一些比较高品质的产品和旅游活动呢？
Well, Belgium is an extraordinary rich country, and if you like to do high-level quality shopping, I mean, first of all, you should definitely go to Brussels, Belgium, Bruges, or Antwerp. Now, of course, you have several other markets.It's like a diamond, and really the diamond sector is so strong in Belgium, so that's definitely a destination.
钻石和巧克力是女人一生的挚爱，在比利时馆里，你既可以欣赏到拥有最顶级加工工艺的钻石，也可以尝到最好吃的巧克力。那么就跟我来一场奢华比利时之旅吧。比利时的第二大城市安德卫普素有钻石之都的美誉，全世界每十颗裸钻中有八颗会送往那里进行加工。此次安德卫普钻石博物馆带来了他们珍藏的十款钻石艺术品，告诉你一颗裸钻如何变身耀眼明钻的传奇故事。
接下来为大家介绍比利时馆钻石区总监 Mickey。
Hello Mickey。
你好。
你可以为我介绍一下比利时钻石的文化吗？
Yes, like you know, we in Antwerp, we have a diamond tradition going back for 550 years. And Antwerp is actually the capital of the diamonds of the world.
那么你能跟我们介绍一下顶级的钻石切割对于钻石的品质意味着什么吗？
Definitely.We in Antwerp do have the best diamond cutters in the world. This is a skill that we have for generation now. To be a good diamond cutter, you have to learn at least 4 years. Let me show you a special edition that we have done from the Shanghai Expo. This jewelry is made by Wolfers, the jeweler of the Queen of Belgium. Here it is. Please try it.
大家可以看到，这就是比利时切割的工艺，非常非常的讲究。很漂亮。 Thank you, Mickey. Have a good time in Shanghai.
不客气。
没有人能经得住巧克力的浓情诱惑，此次比利时馆邀请了最著名的四大顶级巧克力品牌和多位巧克力制作大师，这里俨然成为了一个梦幻的巧克力工厂。大家都知道比利时有着全世界最好的巧克力，那么比利时巧克力的特色在哪里呢？接下来我就要问一下我旁边这位巧克力大师 David。
Hello David. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. 你可以为大家介绍一下吗？
Well, in Belgium we have a long tradition of making chocolate. We produce the world's best chocolate. It has a very fine structure that is different than all the other chocolates in the world.
那么比利时巧克力在制作过程是怎么样的呢？
Well, to work with chocolate, we need perfect conditions. It has to be a cooled area. We can't have humidity. We have to be creative.
在这次世博会，比利时巧克力推出了什么样特色的巧克力给大家呢？
At the expo, we produce a special chocolate with a little blue man on it, and we produce a chocolate with a I Love World Expo on it. You can taste the chocolate if you want.
Yeah.
Real Belgian.
在比利时馆的二楼餐厅里，长长的啤酒吧台上供应着20多款地道的比利时啤酒。参观的间隙，可以在原汁原味的比利时美食中大快朵颐，也可以捧着一杯啤酒，在户外的露台上欣赏世博的夜景，顿时有了一种置身欧洲的优雅情调。
站在我旁边的是餐厅的负责人 Thomas， 他将告诉我们一些比利时的饮食文化。Hello, Thomas.
Hello.
你能具体跟我们介绍一下比利时的一些特色的菜肴吗？
Yes, in this Belgian beer cafe, we serve only the typical Belgian food, the one that I grew up with back in Belgium. So it's very traditional. For instance, we have a wonderful starter that is made of baked endives with ham in a famous Belgian cream called bechamel sauce.
是否可以给我们介绍一下比利时啤酒的典故？
I'm going to serve you one, which is a new beer that we are launching now in China. It's a beer made out of sour cherries. We made in the region of Brussels. And it's very famous for its sweet and sour taste. In Belgium, we pair it always with the chocolate kind of dessert. So we try to match beer with food, just like a French sommelier would do with wine.
本期节目我们带你走进了比利时馆，让您亲身领略了关于世博的奢华旅程，同时也感受到了世博游对于中国高端旅游服务的积极推动。作为首次在中国举办的世博盛会，中国本土的奢侈品牌和服务将如何精彩地展现呢？下一期节目我们将一一为你呈现。谢谢收看本期节目，再见。